today we do something very easy. You can do this at home very easily. It's we pickle, but for this recipe, we just need water. I cook it already here. I have salt, sugar, mustard seeds. I have white wine vinegar. I have a little bit of herbs. You can use it. I take estragon, but you could use dill, whatever you have around. And it depends also a little bit what do you put into the glasses. We add a little bit of radish. I'm already adding the salt in here. The sugar, we cook it up. And the seeds. And the vinegar, I take a simple white wine vinegar. And at the end, we add the herbs, laurel, juniper, estragon. We cook up this whole thing. I already sterilized the glasses, so I don't want to touch the gum around. I have also put up a pot of water to sterilize it afterwards. You can make it like that at home. When you fill the glasses with hot liquid, you close it down and then you put it back into the water. You sterilize it in here for approximately 15 minutes. So we cook it up. I get prepare the radish. You can leave the green on it. Don't put off too much. That's fine. And normally we use two. I've cleaned them already with water. And normally we use two benches of radish per glass. Pickling is something you can find all over the world. And we love to eat pickles with cheese. So if you eat a cheese fondue or a raclette, which is also very typical Swiss, we always serve something pickled with it, or the little pickled onions or the little pickled cucumbers. We like to eat sour. We don't pickle only in sour things. We also use a lot of compotes because the winter used to be hard former days. All the farmers and all the people in the mountains, they always used to get prepared for the winter, for the long winter, and it's a way how to preserve. But in this region here, we use a lot of drying things. So we have this very famous dried meat, maybe you've sure heard about it, meat de grison. It's like a little bit the ham from Italy or from Spain. We are quite in a high altitude. We can dry it. We don't have to smoke it. We can just dry it. Most of the time they dry it upstairs on the roof. They dry it over 2-3 months, and then you get this cured beef, this cured meat. And this is very typical also for this region.
So we have still a little bit more space here in these glasses.
You can pickle so many things, but my absolute favorite pickled ingredient is asparagus. We have some very nice asparagus farmers, and the small ones, and only the top of it. We pickle them exactly with the same liquid, and they're just amazing. This is my absolutely favorite pickle. The liquid is cooking, so we now stir it over, just up to the top, here as well, up to the top. Now close the glass, close it well, make sure that things are clean. So now you can add it into the cooking water. I make one in here, just let it cook 15 minutes, or we put it up here, and we add it into the steam and we leave it in here for 20 minutes. But at home, you don't, maybe don't have a steam oven, so it's also working like that, huh? You can even put it flat inside that you really cook it out, huh? Cook it out for 15 to 20 minutes. Here we have already some finished ones. You can see, perfect with the cheese fondue, perfect with the raclette, but also with this dried meat, which we have a lot in this region. In the afternoon, when you take like a little break, 4 o'clock, you cut up some dried meat, a piece of cheese from the mountains, and then some different pickles. I think that's something which is quite traditionally as well for this canton. Make sure that it's very sterile in here, that you cook it long enough. It's important, otherwise it's gonna break, it's gonna turn into poison sometimes. I think it would be a pity if you put a lot of work into it and then you didn't work very clean and very good, and then all of a sudden you cannot use the product at the end. There would be a lot of waste, so make sure that you make it properly. I think that's it. Thank you very much.